carried the burden of our sin so he could give us the blessing of life. Welcome to today's encouragement from Our Daily Bread. He Carried Our Burden is the title of today's reading, and it was written by Marvin Williams. It's not unusual for utility bills to be surprisingly high, but Kieran Healy of North Carolina received a water bill that would make your heart stop. The notification said that he owed $100 million. Confident he hadn't used that much water the previous month, Healy jokingly asked if he could pay the bill in installments. Owing a $100 million debt would be an overwhelming burden, but that pales in comparison to the real and immeasurable burden sin causes us to carry. Attempting to carry the burden and consequences of our own sins ultimately leaves us feeling tired and riddled with guilt and shame. The truth is, we are incapable of carrying this load, and we were never meant to. As Peter reminded believers in 1 Peter 2, only Jesus, the sinless Son of God, could carry the heavy burden of our sin and its weighty consequences. In his death on the cross, Jesus took all our wrongdoing on himself and offered us his forgiveness. Because he carried our burden, we don't have to suffer the punishment we deserve. Instead of living in fear or guilt, the empty way of life handed down to us, we can enjoy a new life of love and freedom. Our scripture reading today is from 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 18 through 25. For you know that it was not with perishable things such as silver or gold that you were redeemed from the empty way of life handed down to you from your ancestors, but with the precious blood of Christ, a lamb without blemish or defect. He was chosen before the creation of the world, but was revealed in these last times for your sake. Through him you believe in God, who raised him from the dead and glorified him, and so your faith and hope are in God. Now that you have purified yourselves by obeying the truth so that you have sincere love for each other, love one another deeply, from the heart. For you have been born again, not of perishable seed, but of imperishable, through the living and enduring word of God. For all people are like grass, and all their glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of the Lord endures forever. And this is the word that was preached to you. Let's pray. Lord, sometimes our guilt and shame can feel so heavy. Help us to release our past and its pain to you and experience your peace, knowing you have carried it all and have set us free. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today's encouragement was provided by Our Daily Bread Ministries.